Good evening, dear ladies. Let's bless בסייעתא דשמיא שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו אמן שהגיע מבשר אליהו הנביא, אליהו התשבי, אליהו גלעדי במהרה משיח בני אליהו וזכור לטוב. I'm reminding you that last lesson we finished עין הרע. And בלי נדר, I will try to make discs only of the Ayin Hara lessons. It was five lessons that you can take the discs and study in your cars everywhere that you are. Listen to the discs. We are starting now. En od milvado. There's nothing besides Hashem. Nothing besides Hashem. This is En od milvado nashim yekarot. But I would like to remind you that this Shabbat is Shabbat Mevarchim Rosh Chodesh Adar Bet, the second Adar. And this is called Shabbat Shkalim. The second Adar, this is now Shabbat Shkalim. Usually when we have one Adar, it's the Shabbat before Rosh Chodesh Adar, the first day of the month of Adar. We have Shabbat Shkalim. There are two books of Torah taking out. One we read, the parasha is Vayakhel, and the other one we read from Parashat Kitisa, the parasha that we had last week. Because over there, dear ladies, it speaks about the Truma of the Shkalim that the children of Israel should give. And Hashem told them to give Machatzita Shekel, half of a shekel. Hashem told them to give machatzita shekel, only half of a shekel, in order, this is machatzit, and not tenth of a shekel, or twentieth of a shekel, or sixtieth of a shekel, only machatzit. And why machatzit? Because machatzit shows us what tzedakah does. The tzaddik is tzedakah, stands for tzedakah. So this is the pushka, the charity box. And this is the coin that we put in the charity box. So he or she who gives tzedakah causes all of the bad things to go away from them, because machatzit, half a shekel, starts with a mem and ends with a taf, which is death, and brings only life around them. You see chai, you see it? Tzedakah brings the word chai around the tzedakah and makes the word death go away. So if there was a decree from heaven that is not good on us, the more we give tzedakah, the more it goes away from us. Open your hands for tzedakah. Don't be cheap with tzedakah. Because the only money that we truly have is the tzedakah money that we give. If we made another Jew happy, this is what we have in heaven. Not the money now that we are eating or doing things or buying a house. The only true money that we have is the money that we gave for tzedakah. When they came, when the reporter came from a journal to interview Rothschild, the Baron Rothschild, he asked him, tell me, how much money do you have? He says, okay, don't tell me with your words, just write it on a piece of paper. So he wrote on a piece of paper an amount of money and he gave it to him. And he says, are you kidding? I know that it's a lot more. So he says, no. The money that you know is not my money. It's Hashem's money. But this is the amount I gave for tzedakah. So this is my money. This is me for myself in the true world. Ba'olam ha'emet. Look, in Tehillim, it says in Tehillim, dear ladies, chapter 112, 112, dear ladies. Pizar natan la'evyonim, he who gives money and charity to poor people, tzidkato omedet lahad. Hashem looks at him as a righteous person forever. Karno tarum bechavod. Takshivu tov, which means Hashem elevates him. The one who, he who opens his hands. We do not need 10 houses, 3, 4 houses. We do not need so many cars. We do not need so many clothing. We do not need so many shoes. We do not need so many bags. We need the true world. And this is the only place that we can gain chavilot, baggages to protect us, to be good advocates for us in the true world, not only for us, for our children, for Klal Yisrael and the whole world. because the whole world stands on charity. It's written in Tehillim, Olam Chesed Yibaneh, Olam Chesed Yibaneh. The world is built with chesed, charity, kindness. You can see that now the world is already spinning to a not so good place, because people become, letzari harav, to my real sorrow, more egocentric, more self-centered, instead of understanding that we came to this world in order to help each other. This is the world of action. In the true world, we cannot do anything anymore. Only here. So each and every one of us has the spark of Hashem inside, a soul inside. Betzalel Elokim bara et Adam. All of us were created in the image of Hashem, in the image of God. So because of this, we need to remember to be kind to each other. Not chas v'shalom, judge each other. Bidiyuk, exactly the opposite. Now the evil inclination has a party all over the world. There are places that it's already conquered. It's their domain. We need to remember that we came to this world to do charity with each other. To make tzedek, tzedakah, charity. Tzedek is it's a true judgment. If you come to court and they judge you exactly by the facts they have. But tzedakah is lefanim meshurat adin. Is being before judgment, trying to solve things before coming to this phase of judgment. This is tzedakah with a hey. Tzion b'mishpat tibateh v'shaveh b'tzedakah with a hey. So dear ladies, machatzit ha-shekel is in order b'siyata d'shmaya that we will have, Hashem will have mercy upon us. And if there was a decree, lo alenu, then it goes away from us. So what do we do before we go from the hour, before in the morning, after we daven and we want to go out to work, or the children to school, or our husband to work, the first thing that we do, we have a cup with coins, we put a hand with the right hand and we put it in the pushka, in the kupatzdaka, in the charity box, dear ladies. So we go out of the house with charity. We kiss the mezuzah, Shomer Daltot Yisrael, which is the name of Hashem, of keeping the doors of the houses of the children of Israel, is written inside. We kiss the mezuzah and we go out of the house. So we are already starting with protection, because nobody knows after we've gone to sleep and a part of our soul went up to Hashem and gave din v'cheshbon about everything that we did in that day. We do not know what kind of decree went out of heaven upon us the next day. So charity saves from everything. A person who gives charity is blessed with 6 blessings. And a person who gives charity also with his mouth, is kind to people, is blessed with 11 blessings. Together it's 6 plus 11, it's 17, the amount of tov, the numerical amount of good. So dear ladies, open your hands, open your hearts, and be nice. Let's be nice to each other. And why this is called Shabbat Shkalim, the Shabbat of Shkalim, of coins. Dear lazy, because it says Be'achad be'adar mashmin el ha-shkalim. It says in the Gemara, Masechet Megillah, on the first of Adar, dear ladies, we hear about the shkalim. Why? Shoalim v'dorshim b'ilchot ha-chag kodem 30 yom. We learn all of the halachot, the Jewish laws of the holiday, 30 days before the holiday comes. And they over here mean the Chag HaPesach, Passover. Why? Because at the first day of the month of Nisan, they collect all the money from the children of Israel when the temple was still built, and then they buy sacrifices, Korban HaTamid, which is parallel to the davening, the tefillot, the prayers that we do 3 days, 3 times a week. It's a parallel to that tefillot, the Korban HaTamid. So they used to gather the money, and on the first day of the month of Nisan, they used to buy all of the sacrifices for Korban HaTamid. So that's why this is called Parashat Shkalim, the Shabbat of Shkalim, dear ladies. And B'siyata D'shmaya, may Hashem help us. You remember that everybody that opens their hands, don't question why they open, if they really deserve, or don't, just give something as a charity. Why? Because Yirmiyahu the prophet said to Hashem, Hashem, the children of Israel are not listening to me. And I'm telling them that the temple is going to be ruined. And I'm telling the women to be righteous and to be modest. And I'm telling the men to see that they won't spell the sperm in vain, and to see B'siyata Dishmaya, that they won't have slaves with them, and they will free all the slaves that they have. But the children of Israel are not listening to me. So I want to bless them, that Hashem, you will give them to the zchut, the merit, to give charity to people who do not deserve charity. That's very weird. It's a weird blessing.
What does it mean?
Yes, to give charity to people who do not deserve to get charity. Because Yirmiyahu Navi has such mercy on the children of Israel. He said, Hashem, I know you work your world midah keneged midah, measure for measure. So if I gave charity to a person who does not deserve it, Hashem says, wait. If I did something, chas v'shalom, that is not right, Hashem says, wait, I have to do charity also with her, because she gave a person that didn't deserve the money that he got. I have to do the same thing with her. Even though the children of Israel do not deserve, I will save them because of the charity. Do you understand? Measure for measure. That's how Hashem rules the world. So even if we gave a person, we shouldn't ask, because if Hashem brought a person next to us, and he's opening his hand and he wants charity, we should give. It's a big thing, because Hashem brought this person. Ein od milvado. There's no one except Hashem. Hashem is the one that pulls the string behind the curtain. He is the one that told this person to come to us. Why we were already in a different reincarnation together, we have a kind of fixing. It's like people who are dating, going to shiduchim. So they meet and they meet and they meet, and it's not this and it's not this, and then sometimes they get very frustrated. But this is also a fixing, because we met already these people before, and we have to meet them again in this world. We already met each other. It's not that this is the first, but we don't remember, because we came in a reincarnation of a human being. We don't remember. If we were chas v'shalom, a plant or an animal, we would remember. Or a wall in the wall, we would remember. But we don't remember, because we're human beings, and the angel gives us a small hit, so we won't remember. So dear ladies, it's very important to give tzedakah. And while we're giving tzedakah, just think of the name of Hashem that you're completing it. Because the tzedakah itself is the yud of the name of Hashem. The hand, your hand that is mushetet, that is given out to give the tzedakah, the hand has five fingers. Five in numerical value is the letter He of Hashem, the first letter He of Hashem. Then we have all of the hand, all of the Zroa. This is the Vav of Hashem. So we already have Yud, K, Vav. And now we have the hand of the second person that receives the tzedakah. It's another hand with five fingers. It means the He of Hashem, the He of Malchut, the last He. We fulfilled the whole name of Hashem in this world, just by thinking about the tzedakah and giving it. So, dear ladies, this is Shabbat Shkalim. I would like to tell you, it's written, Moshe Rabbeinu said, Ata eret al adat ki hu ha'elokim ein od milvado. That Hashem is God, and there's no God except Him. There's nothing except Him. Everything that you see in this world, everything that we see, even the air, everything, the water, all the things that you see around you, everything has the essence of Hashem. Everything is God, and God is everything. It's just an illusion that we think that we are standing without any power that makes us move, or anything that is controlling the world. There's one creator to the world, and everything is Him, and He is everything. It's like a big light, a roll of light that becomes dims a little by little until it becomes physical in this world. And we are just over here for a big test. So it depends on our emunah, our faith, b'siyata dishmaya, to see b'siyata dishmaya that everything is from Hashem. It's very hard today because the technology is very developed. We don't even have time to sit with ourselves for a minute just to think of what's going on in the world and doing it bodedut, to be alone with Hashem and to speak to Him. This is the best prayer in the world, to sit with Hashem and speak to Him and to be honest with Hashem. Hashem, I did A, B, C, D, E, and I did these good things, b'siyata dishmaya. Please help me. Help me to overcome my anger. Help me to overcome my jealousy. Help if people are going against me, please give me chen v'chesed they will find me nice and they will like me. Help me like it did to Esther, Bezat Hashem, Esther Amalka, that everybody liked her, all of the nations, everybody thought that she was part of their people. So you sit with Hashem and you speak to Him, because there's nothing else except Hashem in this world. Now I would like to go with you to Masechet Sanhedrin in the Gemara, dear ladies. And it's written over there about Rabbi Chanina. It says, I wrote it over here. I don't think so, Ken. Okay, so I'm going to give it to you like this. I forgot to write you on the board, because usually I like to write you something so you can remember. It's in page 67. And it's written like this, Sanhedrin, page 67, Amud Ayin Bet. Ein od milvado, which means there is none besides Hashem, beside Him. Amar Rabbi Chanina, afilu lidvar kshafim, even for sorcery. Even for sorcery, there is none besides Hashem. It says a story about Rabbi Chanina. There was a woman sorcerer, mechashefet, mechashefa. You know what sorcery is? A witch. Yes, a witch, a woman witch that went behind him. And he saw that wherever she goes behind him, and she's taking earth under his feet. That's what the Gemara says. Taking earth, ta'adama. Under his feet. Wherever he steps, she goes, she takes earth. That's what the Gemara says. So he turned around to her and he says like this, why did she take the earth under his feet? To do magic to him, in order to harm him. Lazik lo bekishufea. Ra'a zot Rabbi Chanina ve'amar la. Rabbi Chanina saw this and he told her, im tatzlichi lakachat afar kchi, if you succeed to take earth that I put my foot on it, take, he says, ve'lechi, and go. Kevan she'eneni mefached mikshafim, because I'm not afraid of magic, of black magic. She'arei en od milvado, because there's nothing except Hashem. Now listen, what did he mean? So Rashi says, im hamakom chafetz bi'if, Hashem loves me, and Hashem loves everybody, but He wants to protect me. Lo tuchli la'arali, you cannot harm me. Ve'im tuchli, and if you harm me with your magic, it means it's from Hashem, and I'm accepting this with love. But it says, it's the Gemara continues, and it says, why wasn't he afraid? Because they say denafi schute, which means he has a lot of merit. Rabbi Chanina, he had a lot of schuyot from Hashem. He studied Torah. He gave a charity. He had a lot of schuyot. He surrounded himself with Torah, dear ladies. He surrounded himself. Once, I told you also about Ayin Hara, evil eye. Once we are a tool of holiness, then nothing can touch us. If we come to Shul Torah, and us as women, we don't have to go to plenty Shul Torah. It's enough one Shul Torah in a week, because we have husbands and children, and the first thing is the husband and the children. It's the home, it's the family. But if we come to a Shul Torah, all of the angels protect us. We go back home. We tell our children. We speak about emunah with our children and our family. We tell them that what does it mean to have emunah? Emunah means that we know that everything is from Hashem. Ein briyah nokefet etzba'a lemata elulech rizo alea lemala. There's no person that can harm me if Hashem didn't take a decree out of heaven. It says in Masechet Chulin, page 7. And the more that we sanctify ourselves, the more nothing can touch us. And the women have the mikveh. Go to the mikveh. Even if you're a widow or you are divorced, go to the mikveh at least 4 times a year, because it cleans you from everything that is, you come out of the mikveh like a baby, like you are just born right now. That, you know, the aura around a woman that goes out of the mikveh is all white. It doesn't matter what she did before. She went out of the mikveh, the aura is white. You remember I told you that the holy auras are purple, and the most holiest one is white. Baby, when he's born, the babies are all white. All energy around them is white, like angels. So, dear ladies, we can cleanse ourselves. Studying Torah, being tzniut, behaving the way Hashem wants us, being modest, like Hashem wants us to be, doing the will of Hashem. You know, all the nations, the children of Israel and all of the nations were very modest in olden days. Not like today. They used to wear dresses and skirts. Everything was long. Nothing was by the knee. Nothing. Everything was long. Everything was covered. Even cover on the hair everybody went with. Everybody knew that. Nobody came close to a woman that has a period. Everybody understood that. Even Lavan. Lavan is running after Yaakov. He took his 2 daughters, the 4 daughters, Bilhah and Zippah were also his daughters. He was running after him to keep with him and to see his daughters and to tell him, why did you take my, like this, like a thief, my daughters and my children? And he tells him, you took my God. Because he had an idol ship and Rachel took it, but Yaakov did not know. So he told him, please search all of the tents. He comes to the tent of his daughter Rachel, and Rachel tells him, sorry, father, I cannot stand up for you. This is respect. Once, it's also written in Shulchan Aruch, dear ladies, it's part of the respect of parents that you stand for them. It's in the Kibud Orim. Respect thy father and mother. It's part of Kibud Orim. So she says, I cannot stand for you because I have the ways of women. He doesn't go into the tent. He knows he cannot go close to her because in the blood there's nefesh. Badam yesh ta nefesh. We're not allowed to eat blood because in the blood there's part of the soul. And when it goes out, it causes ruach, ruach shel nida. It's like a bad spirit around a woman. That's why we're not allowed, the men are not allowed to go in between 2 women. We're going to study this too, Bezrat Hashem. After this, we're going to study Dinei Yichud v'Siyata Dishmaya, Bli Neder.
So why she didn't...
Wait. So I'm just giving you an example to see that even the Goyim knew that this is out... that you're not allowed to do this. So, dear ladies, the more you become holy, the less anything can touch you. Anything that is not good. Only good things. You become a container of Hashem, of everything that comes good from Hashem, the light of Hashem. You become a container. So I want to tell you this, dear ladies. I gave you this story, and now we are opening Enod Milvado. There's nothing except Hashem. So we're going back to Chumash. Now we're going to go through the Torah, all the whole books of the Torah, Bli Neder B'Siyata D'Shmaya. But we are starting with Chumash Vayikra, the portion of Tzav. And it's written, Zot HaTorah Lemincha V'Lechatat V'Le'Hashem. This is the Torah for, these are the sacrifices, the sacrifice of Mincha, the sacrifice of Chatat, and the sacrifice of Hashem. When a person does a thing that that wasn't in the will of Hashem, and he has to bring the sacrifices to the Mishkan, to the tent, or to the temple. So we're now going to Parashat Ekev. We're coming back to this B'Siyata D'Shmaya. And in Parashat Ekev, in Chumash Dvarim, it's written, Moshe Rabbeinu tells the children of Israel, Ki agorti mipnei ha'af v'achema. I was afraid of 2 destructive angels. One is af, is anger, and the other chema is wrath. Asher katzaf Hashem alechem, that Hashem was angry with you, la'ashmid etchem v'ishma Hashem elai gam b'pamai. And Hashem wanted to חס ושלום, to do a harsh thing to the children of Israel, but Hashem listened to me, and he didn't do it. So what did Hashem want to do to the children of Israel? This, we're going back to Parashat Ki Tissa. Last week we had Parashat Ki Tissa, we read it in the synagogue, and we are reading part of it, Parashat Shkalim, this week. And there was the sin of the golden calf, Chet Ha'Egel. And when the children of Israel did the Egel, and it wasn't the children of Israel, it started with the Erev Rav. Who are the Erev Rav? They were the ones that Moshe Rabbeinu converted, the Egyptians that saw the 10 plagues in Egypt, and they were afraid of Hashem, and they converted and became Jewish. And Hashem told Moshe Rabbeinu, leave them there and don't take them with you, but Moshe Rabbeinu insisted, and he took them with him. So this one was the one that did not see that Moshe Rabbeinu come on time, because they saw that he was late after 6 hours. He did not come yet. Instead of waiting until the night, they asked to build an idol, an egel. That was part of it. It had an ox figure and the back part was a donkey figure. Two things, Shor v'Chamor. And we had lessons about Shor v'Chamor. It's Ishmael, you remember, and the Dom, connected together. So they, Aaron took all of the jewelry of the men and not the women, because the women did not sin, and he put it inside a burning place, and this Egel went out, came from it. It says, B'me'am Lo'ez, that because of the sin, 5 destructive angels came in order to cause damage to the children of Israel. 5. Why? Because they sinned 5 sins. One of them, because they worshipped an idol, another god. So, kafru b'Hashem. The second thing, fiyu tova klapei Moshe. They were ungrateful to Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu, that was in Egypt with them, that showed them the 10 plagues that came from Hashem, that helped them with the man, that they will have food, that helped them with a meimara. You remember, they didn't have something to drink, and he asked Hashem, and Hashem helped him. He asked from Hashem to help him, that this sour water will become sweet. Everything that he did for them, they didn't have the patience to wait a few more hours that Moshe Rabbeinu will come down from Mount Sinai. The third sin, that they bowed to the idol. The fourth sin, that they gave sacrifice to the idol. And the worst sin was that they danced around the idol. Because when a person does a sin, so sometimes you do something that is not in the will of Hashem, but then after that you feel, you regret, you say, wow, what did I do? That was wrong. I shouldn't have done this.
It's very rough. It's not a Jewish.
Yeah, but they took also the ones who didn't have strong emunah with them. So, dear ladies, and they were considered Jewish because they converted. So, dear ladies, I would like to explain. Why was this the harshest sin? Because they danced, it means that they didn't have any regret. They didn't think to take an idol to exchange Hashem. That wasn't the purpose. They wanted to exchange Moshe Rabbeinu, somebody that will lead them. It wasn't to exchange Hashem. It's to exchange a leader. But look what happened. And why all of this is connected to Enod Milvado. So Moshe Rabbeinu was davening for the children of Israel. And he said to Hashem, Hashem, I know they didn't do your will. And he said, I know what you want to do to them, but please forgive them. In the merit, in the zchut of Avraham Avinu, forgive them for bowing to the idol. Ze Avraham Avinu. In the merit, why? Because Avraham Avinu was in the time when everybody bowed to Nimrod. Everybody believed that the statues that are made, the idols that are made from stone and are made of wood, dear ladies, this is God. That's what they believed, Chas v'Shalom. So Avraham Avinu was the only one who told everybody that this is not God. God is in heaven and he's the one that created the world. And he was willing to die in the name of God. And Nimrod took him and he put him in the fire for 3 days. So in the schut of Avraham Avinu that was in the fire, and Hashem saved him, and he went out of the fire alive for 3 days, dear ladies, he says, forgive the children of Israel. And then they sacrifices, he says, in the schut of Yitzchak, that was willing to be a sacrifice on the altar for you, Hashem. Forgive his children. And in the schut of Yaakov, forgive them for dancing and being happy. Remember Yaakov Avinu that had so much sorrow. Sorrow from Esav. Sorrow from Lavan. Sorrow from Dinah. Sorrow from Yosef HaTzadik. He says Rachel, sorrow from Rachel that passed away when she gave birth to Binyamin. For his sorrow, forgive them for them being happy around the idol. So Avraham Avinu took one of the angels, one of the destructive angels, and could overcome him. The merit of Yitzchak Avinu was to overcome the second angel, the third angel by Yaakov Avinu. But there were two more angels that stayed. Af v'chema, wrath and anger. Two more angels. We will speak about it in a minute, about this Bli Neder angels. So we go to Masechet Minchot in the Gemara, page 110, Amud Bet. It's written, Kol haosek batorah ki'ilu ikriv ola chatat ve'asham. He who studies the Torah, it's like he gave already ola chatat ve'asham, all of the sacrifices that you need to give in the temple or in the tent, in the holy tent, in order to take off the sins that you did towards Hashem. And Amar Rabba, Kol haosek batorah eino tzarich lo ola lo chatat ve'lo Hashem. He who studies Torah does not need any sacrifice. What does it mean? Everything is connected. You will see in a minute. We'll connect everything. Today we don't have temple. So we study. We don't have the temple. We can't give sacrifices. So the question is, how can we atone to ourselves? How can we make Hashem happy with us? So if we study the Torah and we do the will of Hashem, we don't need the sacrifices. I thought I forgot something here. Zot HaTorah, just a minute, I'll write it again because Le'olah tzarich liot po first. Okay. So, you remember we spoke about the destructive angels? In order that these angels will not come and chas v'shalom harm the children of Israel, we give these sacrifices, because once we don't listen to Hashem, we cause these angels to come and harm us. We cause them by our own actions. Our own deeds cause these bad angels to come and touch us. So, dear ladies, who are these angels? It says, "Betikunei HaZohar." You know, remember the Tehillim chapter 78? So in chapter 78, it's written, Vehu Rachum, Hashem is very merciful. Yechaper Avon, He will forgive us for all of our sins. Velo Yashchit, and He won't destroy us. Virba Lashiva Po, and He will calm Himself and won't be angry. Velo Yair Kol Chamato, and He won't wake up all of His wrath. So the Tikkunei HaZohar says, dear ladies, it says over there, Vehu Rachum Yechaper Avon, Avon is the Ayin of here of Ola, you see? This is parallel to Avon. Ola, it's in order to take off the angel that is called Avon. This is a destructive angel that has angels beneath him. And he's the head of the angel. He's called La'alenu Avon. Ve'lo yashchit, and over here we have Veloya Shchit, Veirba Lashiva Po. Apo is over here, you see Hashem, that when we give sacrifice of Hashem, we calm down that the angel that is called Af will not come to us. And then Chamato, the wrath of Hashem, dear ladies, the angel is that is called Chema, dear ladies, cannot come to us because of the sacrifice of Chatat. And then we have another angel, Yashchit, which is called Mashchit, destructive, Mashchit. This is the fourth angel. These are four angels that are destructive angels that wanted to come and harm the children of Israel when they had the sin with the golden calf. These are angels that have beneath them other angels that they send them as messengers. These are the head of the angels. So when we give sacrifice in the temple, Hashem protects us from all of these angels. But now we don't have the temple. So when we study the Torah and we study Bechumash Vayikra, all of the dinim, all of the halachot, the Jewish laws about the sacrifices of Olah, Mincha, Chatat, Ve'asham, by studying and by doing the will of Hashem, all of these angels cannot touch us. Let's look, how do we know that this is also, this is true? We go to Parashat Yitro. You remember the children of Israel were receiving the Torah on Ma'amad al-Sinai, on the mountain of Sinai. And Yitro comes to Moshe Rabbeinu, he was his father-in-law. And he was a high priest of idleness. There wasn't any idol that he didn't worship. He comes to Moshe Rabbeinu. He sees how Moshe Rabbeinu judges the people. And he says, you cannot do this. You have to put people underneath you and they will judge. And only things that are hard for them, they will come to you. But look what he tells him. He wants the children of Israel to be protected because he also converted to Judaism. He became Jewish. So he says, dear ladies, here, I wrote it over here. Vatate chaze mikol ha'am anshei chai lirei Elokim anshei emet sonei betza. He says, put righteous people that have a lot of money, that they won't take any bribe from anybody. And they have the fear of Hashem. Vesamta aleim, and put on them. Sarei alafim, ministers of thousands. Sarei meot, ministers of hundreds, v'sarei chamishim, ministers of 50, and sarei asorot, ministers of 10, which means over 10 people, put a minister. Over 10 ministers, put over them one over 50, and then one over 100, and then one over 1,000. It's like a pyramid. But what did he mean? When he said that, there was a secret in this. Because when he said alafim, thousand, it starts with an alef in order that the angel, destructive angel of af, of anger, won't be upon them. When he said meot, dear ladies, he meant the hundreds, he meant that the angel mashchit won't be on them. The angel with his mashchit is the clue. You see the mem? It's from Ashchit. You see over here, the Mem of Mincha? And then when he told them, Sarei Chamishim, it's the angel of Chema, of wrath. And when he told them, Sarei Asarot, which means the ministers of 10th, these are the angels of Avon, that the angel, the destructive angel of Avon, of sin, cannot touch them. The Chamishim Zechema, Zachet Shel Chema, which means the wrath, the angel of this, the destructive angel of wrath cannot touch them. Once they have this pyramid and righteous people are above them, so then B'siyata Dishma, the schud, the merit of those righteous people will protect them, and then B'siyata Dishmaya, all of these destructive angels cannot touch them. All this is connected to Enon Milvado. It's an opening lesson. We are not going to finish it today. So I want to tell you another thing. So that's why, dear ladies, also in the Mabul, in the flood, we can see that four times, I didn't write because I didn't have a place to write it over here. I'll give you the verse from the Torah over here. Oh, yeah, the Mabul, the flood, dear ladies, it's written over there. Four times that the water became harsher. The first time that the water flooded all the land and they became harsher. And then again, v'amayim gavru me'od me'od. And the water became harsher and harsher. Al haaretz, on earth. And then it's written, Chamesh Esre Ama, 15 Ama, it's the height. Milemala Gaveru Amaim, again harsher, the water became harsh because of the four destructive angels. Veichasu Harim, Veigveru again Amaim. They covered all of the mountains and they became more harsher. Al Haaretz, Chamishim Umeat Yom, 150 days. Dear ladies, these are four times the water became harsher and harsher, four times parallel to the four destructive angels. Dear ladies, So how do we protect ourselves? Sorry? Okay, at the end, write on the lesson, I'll answer at the end. So how do we protect ourselves? We say Shema Yisrael. Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad. We say Shema Yisrael. And we say En Od Milvado, but I will go into En Milvado, Bli Neder, in the future lessons, because I want to show you, then you will understand how it's important to say En Od Milvado. Why do we say Enod Milvado? And what kind of power it has? We started with magic because Enod Milvado takes away magic. You saw Rabbi Hanina said, Enod Milvado. But in order to understand why it takes, we need to learn all of this. So Shema Yisrael. Shema starts with a big shin and ends with a big Daled. Daled Rabbati. Together it's shed, demon. Destructive angel. By saying Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, we take away from ourselves and Klal Yisrael those four destructive angels. How do we take them? What's left from Shema is Mem Ve'ayim, and what's left from Echad is Aleph and Chet. Look, dear ladies, Mem is Mashchit, stands for Mashchit. Ayin is Avon, Aleph is Af, Raf, and Chet is Chema, which is, Aleph is Af, which is anger, and Chet is for Chema, which is wrath. All of the four destructive angels. All of the four destructive angels cannot touch us with a Shema Yisrael. So when we go to sleep and we sit on our bed and we say Shema Yisrael, it's like we are having a sword that has two mouths. Cherev pipiot.
What was the Dalet?
Ze shed. Toa shin ve Dalet ze shed. Ze lakachat et the destructive angels.
No, but what came down, what trickled down was the...
What's left is from Shema, from the word Shema. Listen. What's left in Hebrew is Mem Ve'ayin. Mem stands for Mashchit, for the destructive angel. Ayin for Avon, for the second destructive angel. And from Echad, one, what's left over is Af, which means that Aleph is for Af, is anger, and Chet is for Chema, it's for wrath. The four destructive angels. So just by doing this, dear ladies, by saying Shema Yisrael, we are taking away from us, Klal Yisrael, all of these destructive angels, that they cannot touch the children of Israel. So, dear ladies, I'm going to finish now for today, over here, and we're going to study Bli Neder next week. Next week, dear ladies, we're going to study about Brit Milah. Why do we do circumcision?
Connections.
It's all about these four destructive angels. And we are going to connect it to Moshe Rabbeinu that was almost killed by the two destructive angels, almost killed by them, because he didn't circumcise his son Eliezer. They came to him as a snake, and they swallowed him from head to his legs, and then they threw him out, and then they swallowed him from his legs to the Brit. We're going to speak about it next lesson, Bezrat Hashem, Bli Neder. Yes, and Tzipora did the circumcision right away. But we're going to go into it and explain through the Gemara what happened and how all of this is, what's happening with these angels, because everything is connected to Enod Milvado. Yes, please.
We always know that everything is from Hashem. So even the golden calf that they did was also from Hashem. So why did Hashem get upset? They were going to do this Avera, and yet you still got upset.
But again, dear ladies, Hashem knows, for example, we are born in this world. Hashem knows already what is going to happen with us. And He knows what will happen if we'll choose this path or choose this path. So dear ladies, the word that we shouldn't take is what we'll choose. The path that a person wants to go through, Hashem opens the path to him. So Hashem says, you are born and I blessed you with ABC and I told you to be righteous. But I did not bless you with right. I didn't tell this person is going to be righteous. I gave you all of the blessings. Righteous or wicked, you will decide when you come to this world. So the children of Israel could have waited. They could have decided to wait, but it's not all of them. It's not all of them that sinned. It was only 3,000 of them because of the Erev Rav. We have Erev Rav Bekirbenu today. It's the generations of Erev Rav that are still Bekirbenu that go against the children of Israel and demonstrate and speak badly and say to boycott the children of Israel. Lo alenu, these are Erev Rav. Erev Rav is the root of Amalek Bekirbenu. This is the Erev Rav. And when Mashiach will come, they won't be here anymore. So don't be mistaken. We have Erev Rav Bekirbenu today, and today it's very hard to distinguish who is Erev Rav and who is not. Only Mashiach can distinguish. So I tell Hashem, how can we be good advocates to this generation? Objectively, it's very hard in this generation to educate children, to be righteous in this world. It's very hard. It's harsher in this generation. It's for him, it's more harsher than the generation that was with Moshe Rabbeinu, because they saw angels. We do not see. They saw Malach HaMavet. They saw the angel of death. Why did they do it? Because Malach HaMavet showed them that Moshe Rabbeinu is dead in heaven and this is his bed.
He lied to them.
But this is en od milvado. A person, for example, if a person does bad things to you, you should understand this is not the person. There's a Hashem. Once you understand that Hashem sends him and nothing can touch you except Hashem, nothing really can touch you. It's a changing the way we think. So how do we do that? We sit with ourselves. Everybody has sorrow today. Everyone, there's nothing, no one that Hashem skips. Everybody has. And in different ways. And everything is very harsh. So we sit with ourselves and say, wait, you know where the evil inclination is? It's in the heart on the left side. That's what the Zohar HaKadosh says. That Yetzer Hara hu b'cheder ha'smali shel ha'lev. But in the heart, in the left room. So what do we do? We sit. How do you prevent him from causing you to think bad thoughts and to get into depression? You sit with yourself and you say, Hashem, I know that everything good only comes from you. You gave me neshama. You gave me presents. If you can't say it, write it. All of the presents that Hashem gave you. Write it on a piece of paper and every morning look at it and you'll become happy. That first of all, I wake up in the morning, Baruch Hashem. I have my feet, I have my hands, Baruch Hashem. I can work, I can do everything. I'm healthy, Baruch Hashem. Everything starts with here, with the mind. Everything, all the whole body goes by the mind. So then you tell to yourself, okay, Hashem, you brought these people to bother me. Please, Hashem, help me. Help me to understand that everything is from you. Help me that they will leave me and not harm me anymore. Help me that they will do tshuva and I will do tshuva. Because this is a fixing. We already met these people in different reincarnations. It's only a fixing. So we don't want to go come again and do that, meet them again. We want to finish the fixing. First of all, forgive. Hashem, I forgive everybody. All the people that did bad to me, that harmed me, I forgive all of them, Hashem. Because they are your children. You told them to come to me and to do whatever they did. But Hashem, please help me. Help me do tshuva. Help them do tshuva. And b'siyata dishmaya, make peace. This is what we need to do. Make peace. First, forgive so you don't have things that you have to complete in the true world. Because averot sheben adam lechavero, sins between people and other people, dear ladies, Hashem does not forgive. And because He does not forgive, we have to come back and meet each other. And we can come back in domem, in things that do not move, and we can come back in plants, we can come back in animals, or in a human being. So we want to stay in heaven, in paradise, in Gan Eden. So first we need to understand what is the true things in this world and what is false. The truth is everything comes from Hashem. Enot milvado. Everything is from Hashem. Nothing comes from human beings. I will give you a hint. When we look at Enon Milvado, he takes away when he say the angel of anger, and he takes away the angel of Avon, and he takes away the angel of Mashchit. It's only, I'm just touching it, we have to speak about it, but just touching it. So, dear ladies, how we can prevent that nothing can touch us, nothing not good can touch us? By cleaning our emunah, by having true faith in Hashem, true bitachon in Hashem, confidence in Hashem, by believing and knowing that there's a shkacha pratit, that Hashem looks at each and every one of us, every minute of a day, every split of a second of a day, and there's a shkacha. And Hashem gives us the tools to be protected. So we give tzedakah, which is very important. We study Torah. We come every week to a shul Torah. We study in the kollel. We teach our children. We keep Shabbat. A person who keeps Shabbat, it's like he kept the whole mitzvot. It says that Dor Enosh, even Dor Enosh, it's at the beginning, Dor Enosh are the descendants of Shet, dear ladies, the son of Adam. And they worshipped other gods. But when they kept Shabbat, Hashem forgave them all of their sins by keeping Shabbat. It says, if the children of Israel kept two Shabbat, all of the children of Israel, only two Shabbatot, immediately Mashiach is here. Immediately the whole world has a fixing. Immediately there's peace all over the world. And all of this world is elevated to a more spiritual place. So, dear ladies, there's nothing beyond Hashem in this world. Hashem is everything, and everything is Hashem. God is everything, and everything is God. We just need to take it upon ourselves and to implement it upon ourselves.
Apply ourselves too.
Yes, but we can do it only by speaking to ourselves. Only by speaking to ourselves. Mamash, a person should take at least half an hour, even at night, when the children are asleep, just to speak to yourself and Hashem. You speak to Hashem, just like you speak to a friend. And tell Hashem, Hashem, thank you for everything that you did for me. Please help me. I have a problem with this and this. Because there's truly no problems in this world. Nashim Yekarot, there's no really problems. Because what is Baya? This is baya, problem, baya. You see baya, problem. This is bore, olam, yiftor hakol. This is baya, there's no really baya. How does Hashem solve everything? Because this is ayin bet shemot shel Hashem. In the word baya, in the word problem, there's already the name of Hashem. Because Ayin Bet, Ayin is 70, Bet is 2, it's 72 names of Hashem. In the problem, there's also, Hashem is in the problem. It's only a test. The problem is a test. It's not true. It's like we make from an elephant. But once we put it in the right standard, dear ladies, and then we have Yud Kei, the name of Hashem. Oh my
God. This is that no.
Shem. Yud Kei Vav Kei. It's the half of the Shem. Ki Yad Al Kesiyah Milchama L'Hashem Be'Amalek Midor Dor.
The soft side or the harsh side?
This is, dear ladies, it's Ashrei HaGever Asher Teyasrenu Ya. This is the part of suffering. We'll speak about it, Bli Neder, but not now. So, dear ladies, in the problem, there's already the solution. Where is the solution? In the hands of Hashem. You just need to speak to Hashem. So Hashem knows that you know that the problem came from Him. So He solves the problem. If I'm not getting married, if I don't have children, the problem is in the hands of Hashem. There's a time and place for everything. But you just need to connect to Hashem. We are not connected. We forget where we came from. Dear ladies, we are the daughters of a king. Anachnu bnot melech. We should behave as bnot melech, as daughters of a king. We should follow the ways of Hashem. Hashem said, cover your hair, we'll cover our hairs. Hashem says, bitzniut, bitzniut. If you don't know what modesty is, learn what modesty is. It's not... Yes, but you are responsible first for yourself. Because once you light your candle, all of the candles around you start to be... Avraham Avinu was one. Avraham Avinu was one, and he had a lot of Erev Rav around surrounding him. His father told Nimrod to throw him to the fire. And you tell me, his father told him, because his father had a store of idolship, and Avraham Avinu broke everything. And he broke and he told him, what did you do? He said, listen, the big idol wanted to eat and the small idol wanted to eat. I gave them food. The small ate before the big one, and the big one came and broke him. And then he broke all the store. So dear ladies, it's not impossible, even though today it's very hard, but we need to light our own candle first. Perach meyapet, atzmo meyapet agan, a flower that makes itself pretty. The whole garden is pretty because of him. So it starts with us. We don't look at others. First us. We should first fix our characteristics, our measures, our emunah. And once we fix ourselves, our children feel us that we are true. And then they will do the same. Even if your children are not now in the way of Hashem, dear ladies, even if you do everything, you're a religious home, and the children went satu me'aderech. Remember what I'm telling you now. What they learned at home, they will come back to it, and they will be more religious than the parents. Why? Because Hashem has a purpose. He knows what He's doing. They will be more religious. Sometimes people go the different directions and come back and bring with them back a lot of people. You won't believe it. I know a woman that insists that she keeps Shabbat, but she insists not to go tzniut. But then one day I was next to her, and she didn't know that I was listening, and I heard her telling another woman, that another girl that is supposed to get married, you know, you should go to the mikveh, you should do this, you should do this. I was so astonished. I didn't show her that I see, you know, sometimes people, I was so astonished. And I said, well, Baruch Hashem, you never know what people, because what they already received at home, it's like a sponge. It's in them. Sometimes they just rebel, but then they come back, and they come big time back. So, dear ladies, it starts with us. We are the example. The way we treat others. Hashem said the second temple was ruined because of false hatred. It will be built because of unconditional love. So Hashem wants us to love each other, and it starts from us. Us. So I would like to bless all of us first. I would like to bless all of us first. B'siyata d'shmei shilgalem Mashiach tzidkenu b'mera b'yameinu amen. She'agia mevasar Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu tishbi. Lo agrid m'ram shechonini l'Eliyahu Navi zachur l'tov. B'siyata d'shmei. We're going to continue. You'll see b'ezrat Hashem next lesson.